All right. It's hard to tell what my opponent's actually going to side in. Like, is he going to have ways to kill doors? Is that not what he's fighting? Oh man, I didn't do a pass on my duels, so now I have the old ones and the new ones. It's annoying. All right, I don't think this is a mulligan. It's a two-lander, but if I draw a third land, I have Chromatic Lantern, and then I've got Wrath into Brasco, which is pretty nice. I guess it doesn't matter too much which I play. I want to play with a land that can cast Terminus, because if my opponent goes Emissary into Nightshade Peddler, though Peddler's probably not in the deck still, and I see Emissary into something, and then I draw a Terminus, I want to be able to cast it. Emissary into Farseek. Jeez, look at that combo ramp action. Next turn, I'm running out Breeding Pool, followed by Sun Petal Lantern, followed by probably Supreme Verdict, but don't actually know yet. I've just turned into a Mono Wrath deck, which seems like a decent place to be against this Humans deck. Though, I don't know. Could have much in a Gates Post board, which I guess is kind of annoying. Let's just play this. Alright, this isn't going too badly. Vraska's not a bad follow-up to Wrath, too. Plus, you can actually kill with Vraska. What is this? 3 mana of the wrong colors. Interesting. Alright, I guess I'm going to get beaten down first. Nope. Domri Rade. That's not bad, but hopefully it misses here. And then I do get to Vraska. Let's see. Domri goes up to 4. Play Chromatic Lantern. Basically, I need to Vraska it before it hits 7. It would be nice if I didn't lose Vraska in the process. Domri goes up to 5, I Wrath, Domri goes up to 6. Alright, miss is not something that's I'm unhappy with. Do I want to Wrath just the one creature? I really want my opponent to tap out for a creature here. Nope. Not going to cooperate, huh? This goes down to 2. If I get negated here, that's pretty annoying. But I don't know if there's a way around that. I could play... Like, I'm just losing the Vraska if I play it. But if I pass, Domri goes up to 6, and I have to play Vraska next turn. And even if I play 2 Lanterns, I'll be a mana short of casting Verdict and Vraska in the same turn. And I do have to kill this before it hits 7. I think that's a little too annoying. Though it does lend more weight to just putting Fogs in the deck, because Fog doesn't care too much about that if you can just Fog every turn. I guess just playing this is okay. Hopefully it does not get negated. And honestly, even if I do have a Wrath, I can still just lose Vraska to an Angel of some kind. Alright, I could also just plus one it. Vraska goes up to 6. And then if it gets attacked, yeah, that seems good. It does run the risk of going Restoration Angel into Domri Rade going ultimate, but at least it kills 2 creatures that way. Maybe that's a little bit ambitious, since the odds that my opponent has Restoration Angel are not incredibly low. Yeah, I got a little carried away there. Well, we'll see what ends up happening. I could also draw Rakdos Return. Ooh, Domri Rade does make me want to... Domri Raid, sorry, I keep saying because of Ole Rade. Domri Raid does make me want to put Rakdos Return on the deck, because it's a decent way to kill that. Ooh, are you going to get some mana? Are you going to use the mana for something? Because that would be awesome. No. So yeah, at this point, it's probably worth it for my opponent just to suicide the Angel and Burning Tree into Vraska, and then have Domri's ultimate versus Vraska. So, in retrospect, I'm a little greedy. Of course, I could also just draw Rakdos Return here, and it would pay off fairly well. Get to return for 4, knock Domri Raid down to 2. Yeah, I mean, I do get to at least, again, eat 2 creatures. This goes back up to 2. I could win with the Assassin Tokens, you never know. So I assume it's still worth it to throw away the 2 creatures. Though this, I guess this goes up to 6. Mine goes down to 1, goes up to 2. Oh, wow. That's not the play I expected. Since now the Angel doesn't even hit me, which at the very least it should have, unless there's something else going on that I'm not privy to. And it could have killed Vraska. Now I get to kill Domri Raid, which I kind of wanted to do pretty badly. And I guess I can just go ahead and cast Supreme Verdict anyway. I mean, opponent could have another Angel, but if he doesn't, then I get value off Vraska here. And also, Angel could have saved Burning Tree Emissary with the Vraska trigger, so Maybe that wasn't there. All right, no creature. Thrag Tusk would be annoying, I suppose. All right, here's where our revelation would be good. No, all right, let's just plus one this. Still, actually, I'm pretty happy with how the last couple turns went, since I basically got to, you know, have my cake and eat it too. I got to kill Domiraid, Vraska live for a turn or two. Granted, it's just going to die now, but it was pretty good value. All right, Vraska down. Get to kill Thrag Tusk, so it makes this Terminus better. Restoration Angel there would have been a beating, by the way. I'm probably going to Wrath away two creatures here. If it's like a Huntmaster or something. Hopefully not another Thrag Tusk. Though that is exactly what it is. Alright. Well, let's cast Terminus. I'd rather take 5 less damage a turn. Alright, now we're just looking for an Evolution or a Sphinx's Revelation. I think either of those actually get me into a pretty good spot. I guess because of Bori Bori Gamos, there is downside to playing all my lands, but because of Increasing Ambition and Sphinx's Revelation, of which there's 5 of in the deck, versus the 1 Bori Bori Gamos, I'm doing a lot better here. Ground Seal. Ooh, interesting. Whiffed on Tracker's Instinct, which I guess is nice for me. Ground Seal does make me want to take Thrag or Snapcaster. Also Rest in Peace? I'm getting a Thrag Tusk off this one at least, but alright. I'm definitely going to cut down on Snapcasters if Ground Seal and Rest in Peace are around. Oh, yes. All right, well, I drew the I drew the 1 Bori Bori Gamos versus the 5 of the cards that make me want more mana, but hey, sometimes you just got to Bori Bori Gamos it up. His ability is going to be relevant here. I'm actually going to be attacking, and like I need to draw lands off it to go deep here. Though I'm actually going pretty deep with Bori Bori Gamos Enraged just in play to begin with. Pretty happy about that, not going to lie. Uh-oh, untapped. Ooh, what could this be? Zealous Conscripts is a beating against Bori Bori Gamos, if that's what's happening here. No Thrag Tusk. Why do you need your lands untapped, though? Interesting. Alright, well, sending in Bori Bori Gamos. He's got... I like the name, too. He's got Trample, so no real reason not to just let him block and then throw some lands at him afterwards. Smash. Granted, this race doesn't favor me, except for the fact that every time he hits, he gets to mulch, basically. And then right now I've got 2 lightning bolts in hand, and hopefully soon to draw more. I guess I don't really have any other way to get value out of cards in my graveyard, but just drawing lightning, you know, getting to draw lightning bolts is already pretty good. I have, what, 7 lands in play, 2 mana, so it's 9 with a 26 land deck? Or is it 27? I think it's 26, but I could be wrong. No, it is 27, so I have 18 land in deck. Didn't take, just took it all. I could just win right now. But not actually true, but all right. Put that in hand. I think, let's see. There's a township here, which I do have to be aware of, so Snug a Beast. I think I just kill all his creatures. That seems pretty good. Kill Thrag Tusk, he gets the beast back, and then I get to kill that too. All right. I'm hellbent, but I have a Enraged Cyclops in play, and my opponent has whatever he finds off Tracker's Instinct, plus maybe a Negate in hand. That's the only card I can really think of that you'd want to keep mana up for. Plus, what are you going to find off Tracker's Instinct that beats this beast? This thing is no joke. You can find a bunch of Restoration Angels and Thrag Tusks. Dissipate, Searing Spear, Cavern, Zygana. Alright, I mean, that's a pretty funny collection of cards to hit off flashing back Tracker's Instinct, but there we have it. Alright, and the second Instinct gets flashbacked. Flashbacked, who knows. Hitting a Burning Tree Emissary, hooray! And putting another Tracker's Instinct in the graveyard. This time I could actually just win, right? I could hit my opponent down to 17. Oh no, even if I draw lands, I have to like draw Sphinx's Revelation to just win now. Alright. Bam. Well, I'm not going to say that wasn't convenient. All right, let's hit the opponent down to 17 and put that in hand and then cast a Sphinx's Revelation for the full amount. Let's see, if I hit enough lands, I just have to hit 5 lands off 7 cards. Easy. Actually, didn't quite hit, but might as well nug the opponent for a little bit of damage. And all right, I guess that'll do it. And I was even going to draw another revelation next turn. All right, Bori Bori, Gamos 1, opponents 0.